Okie dokie, Vlogmas, day 14. Well, my knee just aches like crazy. Of course it is, because this is going out for coffee day. The one time a week I get to get the hell out of the house, or apartment, or whatever. Anyways, the prompt for the day is Christmas memory. What is your favorite childhood Christmas memory? Itchy nose, of course, which literally only happens, well, 90% of the time it only happens when I'm on camera. And the itchy ear, of course, which is more common than the itchy nose. So, yeah. Logger's itch. Anyways, favorite childhood Christmas memory. You know, it's been a long time since I was a kid, and I've lost a good number of memories from my youth for one reason or another. I don't know why. It's just some of us lose those. They go away. And other people, their more recent memories fail them, and they have clarity of their childhood. Absolute clarity. Every moment they can remember. But not me. Not me. It's gone. But there was one Christmas where we had my cousins were over for the Christmas meal, which was rare because we almost never had anyone over for the Christmas meal. In fact, it's probably only one of two times, and the other time was Jesus, was when my one uncle and aunt came to have the meal. I don't think anyone ever came for Thanksgiving ever. They came after the meal in the evening to say hi and have drinks, but you know. Anyways, that was usually the Christmas thing as well. They would come in the evening and say hi and have drinks, basically. But yeah, it was really fun to have my cousins over in my own home ground, so to speak. And it was really quite enjoyable to have happened to be able to play with them and to be able to open the presents that their parents got us and my parents got them together was really quite a fun thing. It was just an extra special Christmas, you know. It had that feeling of family magnified, basically. There was always a feeling of family with Christmas and Thanksgiving and whatnot, and Easter. But that particular time, it was amplified, and it felt really good. So, I don't remember what my parents got me. I think it was clothing, because by this time, I had stopped really playing with toys, even though I did pretend games a lot for several years after that. I had stopped playing with my toys, and I just didn't want them to buy me toys. I even told them I didn't want them to buy me toys. So I got clothing and all that, right? Which was fine. What I do remember was what my uncle and aunt got me, which was the Dynasty album from Kiss. And I really thought that was cool. The year previously, they had gotten me an Eagles album. It had the Long Run on it. I'm not sure. It could have actually. Album name could have actually been The Long Run. I don't know. It's been a long time since I've seen that record. At least 20 years. So, yeah. I got rid of all my vinyl. I sold it many years ago because my record player died, and I just wasn't going to keep it, and I wasn't going to sell it in the newspaper or anything like that. So I just took it to the record store and got like $5 for the whole lot of them, which was a ripoff, but it was better than nothing, basically. Kiss Dynasty was a pretty good album. I think Detroit Rock City was more fun, if you ask me. Itchy. The fibro itch is coming back. It went away, and it's back. You have no idea how annoying fibromyalgia itch is, because your entire body from head to toe itches, and nothing helps make the itch go away. Nothing. Nothing. So, yeah. And you can use all the creams you want. You can use all the pills you want. It's not gonna help. It's rather annoying. It's rather annoying, and it can last days and days. This is the longest flare I've had in years, in probably, again, 20 years. Usually my flares last like a day, and I'm done. But this one has been a slow burn. It's not been really that bad, except the itch, which is terrible. The pain hasn't been excessive. I have been in so much pain from fibromyalgia that I literally begged God to kill me. So it can be really, really bad. And I mean really, really bad. But I've learned to tolerate the pain over the decades that I've had fibromyalgia. So it's all good. No more begging God to kill me. Why people with chronic pain get used to the pain and they don't show it like other people. A normal person that's in pain has visible signs that they're in pain. A person that lives with chronic pain, when they're in pain most of their life, most of their time, to some degree or not, they don't. They just look normal, like it's an everyday and they're not in pain. And it's why doctors in general, Jesus, it's why doctors in general don't believe you are in chronic pain most of the time. A lot of chronic pain sufferers have had many, many experiences with doctors where they didn't get any satisfaction whatsoever because they did not believe them. Yeah, I'm fortunate to have a doctor that does believe me, but that being said, I don't actually do the pain med thing. A particularly bad flare, I might go and get some gummies and take the gummies because they have the magic formula in them, you know what I mean? I don't want to say it on here because of the bots. There's a T, it starts with T and ends in C. And it's a fun chemical if you don't have schizoaffective disorder or schizophrenia or bipolar. But if you do have one of those, it's not really that much fun because I hear voices in the back of my head all the time. It's nonstop when I'm conscious, I hear them. It's just that simple. And they get really freaking loud when I take the gummies, okay? But it manages the pain like nothing else can do. I've had all kinds of stuff. I paid literally $10 a pill for pain medication and not had anywhere close to the the pain relief that the pot gummies give me. So, you know, I do actually have to take like four or five of them because they're only 10 milligrams here in Saskatchewan by law. So I have to take multiples of them, or I have to get them from a person in Regina who makes them. And it's a sketchy deal because it's not quite legal. But she does this for pain relief for many, many people, and it's good. If you ask me, she'll make custom doses and get a 50 milligram one from her, and it'll be fine. I'll get myself about 6 or 8 hours worth of pain relief. It takes 30 to 45 minutes almost always for it to kick in. Now, some other people, it can take literally 12 hours for them to kick in. So, you got to know your body, I guess. But yeah, it helps. But there's a price to pay. There's a big price to pay, and paranoia and whatnot. So, yeah, lots of side effects for me. We'll just put it that way. But yeah, I sure as hell won't be doing it recreationally. That's for damn sure. Because it's not fun, but it's less terrible than being in a lot of pain. When I'm in like level 8 or level 9 pain, and I am just you know, drifting in and out of consciousness because it hurts so bloody much, you know, I'm just about passing out from the pain. It's a bloody blessing to have that available. We'll just put it that way. Okay. Anyways, I gave one to my mom. It just made her super paranoid and super tired, and it didn't really relieve her pain for one reason or another. But she was just so freaking paranoid. Oh my God. She was sure there were people coming for her. You know, I had to sit there the entire day and reassure her that nobody's coming to get her and stuff like that. Yeah. It was horrible. It was horrible. Yeah. So there's a definite downside to the product. Yeah. For some people, for most people, there is really no downside to it. Unless you take too much, then you get really sick. Puke your guts out. But yeah. If you take too much, you can get very, very sick. And of course, some people are allergic to it, and they can be very physically ill, even on a low dose. They can be very physically ill, and it can make you trigger a severe anxiety attack, the likes of which you have probably never experienced without the product. Yeah, the kind that sends you to the ER because you are sure you're going to die, you know? So yeah, there is the dark side, to say the least. But yeah, and they're bloody expensive. They're bloody expensive. So it's what, $15 for two of these things, two 10 milligram ones. Now, I can for $20 get a 50 milligram one, like I say, custom made. So, you know, and if you talk to her nice, you can get away with $15. So, you know, but that's life. I digress. Anyways, I guess I don't digress. It's good information to know. Yippers. Anyways, that's it. That's all. You have a fabulous day and keep smiling. And never, ever, ever give your pets that product. Never, never. Bad idea. No. Harm pets. Harm pets. Have a good one.